Hello and welcome to the class on coefficient of inbreeding. The mating between closely related individuals is known as inbreeding, and the progeny which is born out of such mating is termed as an inbred individual. The inbred individuals have one or more common ancestors. The term coefficient of inbreeding denotes the probability of two genes at a given locus in an inbred individual to be identical by descent. Identical by descent means that the copy of same gene is coming from the common ancestor through sire and through the dam to the inbred individual. It has various synonyms. Inbreeding coefficient is denoted with letter capital F and it ranges between 0 to 1. Sewall Wright have devised a method to compute the inbreeding coefficient. He developed the procedure to measure the degree of inbreeding within an individual with the help of path coefficient. This is the formula proposed by Wright to calculate inbreeding coefficient of an individual X. This formula is Fx is equal to summation 1 half raised to n1 plus n2 plus 1 multiplied by 1 plus Fa, where Fx denotes inbreeding coefficient of individual X, n1 is the number of generations or arrows between sire and the common ancestor, n2 are the number of generations or arrows between dam and common ancestor, and Fa is the inbreeding coefficient of common ancestor. The steps involved in calculating inbreeding coefficient are: initially draw the pedigree diagram, then convert the names of pedigree in alphabets or numbers. You should use the unique alphabet for a given individual. Convert pedigree diagram into an arrow style pedigree diagram. Count the number of arrows towards one parent, that is N1, and count the number of arrows towards another parent, that is dam, that is called as N2. Use the values of N1 and N2 in the formula and calculate the inbreeding coefficient. Here you can see an example of a pedigree. Pedigree is nothing but a systematic list or record of the ancestors in past few generations of an individual. This is the pedigree of Raja, where Sheru is the sire, Dolly is the dam, and Tommy and Rani are the sire and dam of Sheru. Similarly, Tommy and Moni are the sire and dam of Dolly. Now the common ancestor. Common ancestor is the individual that appears in both sire's as well as dam side of pedigree of an individual. This common ancestor transmits its genes to the inbred individual through sire as well as through the dam. Here you can see that Tommy appears in both sire as well as dam side. Therefore, Tommy is the common ancestor of Raja. Next step is to convert the pedigree diagram into an arrow style pedigree diagram. The arrows must be pointed towards the progeny. The individual should not be repeated in the arrow diagram, and those arrows and individual should be deleted which are not pointing towards father and mother or both. Now here you can see that the pedigree of Raja has been converted into an arrow style pedigree, where Raja is identified with letter capital X, sire is identified with letter capital S, dam is identified with letter capital D, and common ancestor Tommy is identified with letter capital T. As you can see, the arrows are pointing towards the progeny. Raja is the progeny of sire and dam. Therefore, the arrows coming from sire and dam are pointing towards Raja or individual X. Sire and dam are the progenies of common ancestor T. Therefore, arrows coming from common ancestor are pointing towards sire and dam. There are certain rules for tracing the path. The path denotes lines or arrows of descent from common ancestor to the individual. The path should connect two parents of the inbred individual either directly or through the common ancestor. The path starts from sire and ends at the dam of the inbred individual. The path starting from sire goes back to the common ancestor, and then it takes the turn towards the dam of the individual. The number of generations between sire and common ancestor are denoted by N1, and those between common ancestor and dam are denoted by N2. The path will move in one direction up to the common ancestor. Reversal of path is not allowed except at the common ancestor. No individual in the path should be counted more than once, and the path cannot pass through the same individual twice. Here you can observe the path of Raja. Here we are connecting sire and dam through the common ancestor. Therefore, STD will be the path of individual Raja. Based on this, we have few exercises for you. You will have to identify the common ancestor, draw the arrow style pedigree diagram, and write the path for the given pedigrees. Here we have provided three pedigrees. First, second, and third. Next exercise is to draw hypothetical pedigree diagrams and arrow diagrams and path for various types of mating, such as sire-daughter mating, grandfather-granddaughter mating, full-sib mating, and half-sib mating. This is the formula given by Wright. Now, if the common ancestor is an inbred individual as shown in the given pedigree, here you can observe that individual B is the common ancestor of individual X, which himself is an inbred individual. Then in that case, we will be using the complete formula of calculation of inbreeding coefficient. If the common ancestor is not inbred, as we have seen in the pedigree of Raja, that T is the common ancestor, but he is not an inbred individual. In that case, the formula can be reduced only up to summation 1/2 raised to n1 plus n2 plus 1. The value of FA, that is inbreeding coefficient of common ancestor, is taken as 0 in this particular case. We will see with the help of solved example how to estimate the inbreeding coefficient of an inbred individual. Again, we will take the pedigree of individual Raja. We have converted this pedigree into an arrow style pedigree, and the inbreeding coefficient of Raja can be calculated with the formula summation 1/2 raised to n1 plus n2 plus 1, since the common ancestor T is not an inbred individual. Therefore, the inbreeding coefficient of Raja is 0.125. It means that Raja contains 0.125 or 12.5% of homozygous genes which are identical by descent. This is another solved example. Here we have to find out the inbreeding coefficient of the individual if he is the progeny of mating grandfather and granddaughter. As you can observe here in this pedigree, that S is the sire of individual X, as well as he is the grandfather of the individual X. Now, this pedigree diagram is converted into an arrow style pedigree diagram as shown here. S will be the common ancestor in this particular case. Now, the inbreeding coefficient of a given individual can also be calculated using this type of table. You can write the name of common ancestor, you can write the path N1, N2, 1, then at the last summation 1/2 raised to n1 plus n2 plus 1 will give the inbreeding coefficient of individual X. Here you can observe that because of grandfather-granddaughter mating, the inbreeding coefficient of given individual is about 12.5%. Based on that, we have few exercises for you. You will have to estimate the inbreeding coefficient of given individuals. In this exercise, you will have to calculate inbreeding coefficient of individual Ram. You can take the help of this table. This is another exercise where you have been provided with an arrow style pedigree diagram of individual X whose inbreeding coefficient needs to be calculated. You can take the help of this particular table. This is another arrow style pedigree diagram where you will have to calculate the inbreeding coefficient of X. You can again take the help of this table. Next exercise is to estimate inbreeding coefficient of individual X if there will be mating between aunt and nephew, or there will be mating between full sibs, or there will be mating between half sibs.